So what are the other differences between additive manufacturing and CNC? The method of creating the final geometry, as we discussed here, whatever the print head is there or whatever the laser is there, that has to go and reach that particular point to create the component. In case of the CNC, the tool has to reach. Since you are having a solid material, in case of the CNC, every point may not be possible to reach by the tool. But in additive manufacturing, since we are creating layer by layer, any point within the object, it is possible to be reached. That is the first difference. Next one is material consumption and wastage. In the first slide, I told material consumed by the CNC machine is very, very high. Apart from the material you are trying to remove, that is going to be a waste. You will be having consumption of lubricants. You will be the consumption of the coolant fluid. So a lot of materials are being consumed. Even the tool, that is going to be worn out very quickly. So tool also you have to replace. Then wastage means whatever material is removed from the workpiece, that is considered as a waste, and you have to remelt it and you have to reuse it. In case of additive manufacturing, there are no coolants, there are no lubricants, there is not much of a material requirement is there. Whatever print head is there, usually that will survive for a very long period of time. Then work material, if you are considering, we are adding material only where it is required. So generally speaking, the material consumption is very, very less in case of the additive manufacturing. It is more in case of the CNC. So if you are seeing for environmental friendly process, so which one will be environmental friendly? Additive manufacturing will be more environmentally friendly because it is consuming less amount of resources. Next one will be the geometric tolerances. Additive manufacturing tolerances are higher, whereas CNC machining we can get very close tolerances. Surface finish. CNC machine surface finish will be very, very good as compared to the additive manufacturing, because in additive manufacturing we are creating layer by layer. So you will be seeing some staircase effect. You will be seeing distinct steps on the surface of the component. The next one is the material choices available. CNC machining can be used virtually for any material. It may be very hard material or it may be very soft material. Everything can be manufactured. It can be metal, it can be ceramic, or it may be plastic. Everything can be machined. But in case of additive manufacturing, there is a very large limitation to the materials you can produce. Some of the materials, it is not at all possible. Mostly, it is used for some plastic materials nowadays and for some metals, which can be used in the powder form, which can be melted by using lasers, and we are able to create a solid component. Next one is the post-processing requirement. Post-processing means after you create the component, what are the additional steps that are required? That is the meaning of post-processing. In case of the CNC, usually the only post-processing required is removing of the sharp edges. Sometimes this is done in the machine itself. Sometimes you have to take it out. You have to use a deburring tool and you are trying to remove unwanted sharp edges from the workpiece. But in additive manufacturing, whatever component you are taking it out, it will be having a lot of issues with respect to the surface finish, with respect to the clearance, with respect to the tolerances which is present, and the texture which is present. So many issues are there. Even the strength will not be very, very good. We have to perform a lot of additional post-processing activities to improve the strength, to improve the surface finish, to improve the dimensional tolerances. So that is another important difference. The last one is the nature of the complex parts. How much complexity of parts you can produce in CNC and additive manufacturing. On a broad sense, whatever components that can be produced in a CNC machine can be produced in additive manufacturing, but reverse is not true because there are a lot of limitations for the CNC because tool cannot reach every point in the workpiece. So additive manufacturing can produce very, very complex shapes, whereas CNC machine can produce complexity up to a limited extent. That is another important difference. So if the question comes, explain the differences between additive manufacturing and CNC, you can write the headings and you can explain them. Always preferable that don't say in one or two word, high complex parts, very high for additive manufacturing, very low for CNC. That will not be a good answer. Sometimes there is a chance of losing marks because of that, such a answers. So these are the major differences between additive manufacturing and CNC machining. So what are the advantages of additive manufacturing? So as we have discussed just now, design complexity and freedom to create very, very complex parts is the advantage of the additive manufacturing. You can see some of the components which are produced. It is mostly hollow from every side, and then on the outer side you are having the solid material. So this is possible because we are building it layer by layer, and these complexities can be achieved. Now you can see a gear, all the material here is completely removed to reduce the weight of the gear, but it will be having the required strength to perform the power transmission. So the other one here, it is a piece of art which is produced. So producing this one using conventional methods is very, very difficult, or it may be sometimes impossible. But in additive manufacturing, it is very easy to produce the complex parts. Now, with respect to design complexity and freedom, you are having another advantage, which is called as customization. For example, you are having a particular need of a component with a particular shape or size. Nobody may be willing to produce for you. So you can go to the 3D printing shop. You can give your design and they may be able to print it, because anything can be printed. Anything can be printed using a 3D printing machine. It may be metal or it may be plastic. Only once you are having the CAD file, then it is possible to create the component. So very, very high customization is possible in case of the additive manufacturing process. That is the advantage. Next one is the speed. So the speed is mainly related to the very, very complex parts. If you are taking very simple components like a shaft and other things, a CNC machine can do it much better. But if you are going for a very complex parts, their additive manufacturing can do it at a much faster rate, because in the CNC machine you may have to have a lot of setup time and other things, but in additive manufacturing it can be done very, very quickly. Another advantage is extremely light design. Since it is possible to get very, very complex curves and profiles on an additive manufactured component, using analysis software it is possible to optimize the material to ensure the light weight of the component. So those optimized shapes may not be possible to produce by conventional machines, but it is very easy to produce in additive manufacturing. That is why we say additive manufactured components can be very less weight. So thereby you are saving the material and you are reducing the cost of the component. The next advantage is it is sustainable and it is environmentally friendly. Since we are consuming less amount of material, there is less amount of scrap, there is less no consumption of lubricants or cutting fluids, we will say additive manufacturing is highly environmental friendly. Next one is no storage cost. Now this no storage cost is mainly applicable for the spare parts, if you are dealing with the spare parts. For example, you are having a requirement of a spare part which is in ABS material, then you need not produce a component and store it in your shop for some few months before a customer will come and take it. So you can have a 3D printer, then immediately when the customer asks for a particular component, you can immediately print that and you can give it to the customer. So you are only storing the material in the very standard form. You are creating the component as and when required, and then you are giving it to the customer. That is why we say there will not be any storage cost, or storage cost is minimized. Next one is increased employment opportunities. Now, how does this improve the employment opportunities? Since this is a new sector, there is a requirement of creating the machines, there is a requirement for designing the components, there is a requirement for creating the programs and operating the machine. Lot of employment opportunities may be created since it is a very new field. So designing of the components will be a completely different for additive manufacturing. There will be broad guidelines will be there. Considering all this, you may have to create the components as per the need. So a lot of employment opportunities will be available. So what are the disadvantages? The main disadvantage is low accuracy. As we have seen in the table earlier, the accuracy levels will be very, very less, because when you are printing the material, as we discuss in the subsequent topics, the volume of the material is going to reduce. There will be some shrinkages. There will be high temperature areas, because of which there will be expansion. So because of all these things, the accuracy achieved by additive manufacturing is very, very less as compared with the CNC machines. Next one is support material removal. So in additive manufacturing, there is a material requirement for supports, that is the overhanging parts. So wherever you are having overhanging structures, you require support material. So after the component is printed, you may have to remove the support materials. Again, you may have to do some polishing or sanding to improve the surface finish. So sometimes it will be very tedious to remove the support material. So it is a problem in case of additive manufacturing. The next disadvantage is limitations of raw material. So as discussed earlier, every material cannot be implemented or used in additive manufacturing. Only few materials can be used in case of additive manufacturing. So that is a limitation. Next one is the material properties. So in case of the CNC machine, you are using material which is either cast or which is either forged or maybe achieved in the form of a standard bar. So we will say the material is having isotropic properties. What is the meaning of isotropic property? If you are measuring the properties in any direction, either in the X direction, Y direction or Z direction, it will be more or less the same. If you are having a block of material, if you are checking the density of the material at any point in that particular block, it will be remain more or less the same. That is the meaning of isotropy. But in case of additive manufacturing, there is a lot of anisotropy. Since you are building it layer by layer, the two layers may not be properly joined. If you are trying to pull the component, it may simply break at the layers and the component may fail. That is a layer adhesion problem, because of which we say there is anisotropy in additive manufactured components, but it is not there in case of the CNC components or any other general components. The next one is IPR. What is IPR? IPR means intellectual property rights, that is a patent and other things. Since if you are getting the CAD file, it is possible to print it. Since the CAD softwares are freely available, you can see a component, you can create the design, reverse engineer it, and you can produce your own components with a new name and you can sell it to the market. So creating a duplicate copy will be very, very easy in case of additive manufacturing, but it is not possible in the conventional process because you don't know exactly what is the process used, what is the accuracy used. Some of the machines may not be available with us, so it may not be possible. But in case of additive manufactured components, since it is possible to scan the component and create the 3D model, the components can be very easily duplicated. So reverse engineering is possible very easily. So there will be a lot of IPR issues in case of the additive manufacturing. The next one is the size limitations. Maybe 4 years back or 3 years back, we can say that there was a lot of issues with the size. The component size that you can manufacture using additive manufacturing was very, very small. But as of today, if we are speaking, we can produce around 2 meter by 2 meter by 1 meter height components. Size restrictions are going out to a large extent. So that disadvantage, if you are speaking as of today, it is not there. But generally speaking, some machines, they are not able to produce very large size of the components, even some processors.